Okay, I don't know what happened, we were disconnected. So let's fix the head. And that will be enough, I think, for today, because let's cut it on these. Must be careful. Just the edges. You will use 1 millimeter clipper, you don't have to do that, but also on the blacks it's sometimes too thin and you can see the skin through it, so it's not so smart. You see, we stripped all this, we stripped between the eyebrows. You can take still a little more down there. All this should actually go off. Yeah. And a little here. Sometimes good to clip the cheeks so you can see how much you still need to strip off. Yeah, somewhere there. So we have the ears. Yes, pretty nice headpiece. And we will brush the beard. And you see here is sticking a little. I don't dare always to go with the machines so close. So I just take the scissors for the edge. And you see it's fixed. Nice. Lovely head. I'll take the smaller scissors just to clip around here. The rest what we didn't strip. Well, then I could take the thinners and just smooth it a little, especially on the sides here. It was just the wool, you know, we stripped what we could, so it's just to smooth it a little. It's really lovely. We will fix the eyebrows. They are a little short actually, so it's not much to work with. It wasn't me, I think it, I don't know, it's always important they will see, so even they can see with the eyebrow. You have to strip a little around, get the shape. We will just give it a little bit on the side so we don't have it. Needs to grow. Then I cut always a little under because you know it's lifting the eyebrow up. I always want that this will be just in one line together with the. With the other eyebrow. hand hairspray on it or anything with that bath, actually. What I shouldn't, but sometimes in the field tent, somewhere in the outdoor show, you will be happy that you landed without any support. Should actually be cropped this dog, it would be lovely in the head. See, here is still a little favorite mushroom after. It's just a big time. I think the head is fixed fairly nice. This will grow, but when it's reaching a little longer out, he will have beautiful head. Actually has nice nature ears. Deal. And of course now they are all directions because it's nothing to be alert about. You see, it's a nice headpiece he got. This, all this, we have to strip this, all this. So this, I think you don't have to look at, but I think it will stop at some point, the streaming. So as long as I can, I will. He's good boy. When it's stopping, I will give him a little pause because he's young dog. This, all this, we will have to strip. You will see, I will take some photos when I'm finished with it. So, you will see him. See, I work with the coarse one and it's just... And all this mess. You see, I'm not moving my wrist at all. And I always do, you know, I'm not keeping on that I have to work on this area or this area. If the dog is more comfortable to sit for a moment, then I move somewhere else. You know, the work will not run away and the comfort of the dog is the most important, because otherwise he will simply hate the grooming, and you need dog which will cooperate. So you have to make them a little comfortable about it. And then you actually have very cooperating dogs which can feel that you are a little with them in it. So it's really important. It's not about just to pull the hair for each prize and put them down and use mouse basket and God knows what, you know, some muzzle. No. The dog must understand that you simply work, we work today and we have to do it. So yeah. And you just support him. You can see I support him here, you know, just that he is relaxing. He's actually hanging on my hand. You see. He's totally relaxed. So that's how we work. And even it's not my dog, he completely trusts me in everything. Now he wants to sit, so okay. Then you want to sit, then we will move somewhere else. This we have to do too. Yeah, I know. What a nice head. Wow. And he knows I like him. I like his head and I like his eyes. He has beautiful head, this dog. So. Well, we are stripping all this down. And here, actually you take it like, I'll try to show you. From here, like this. So all this you strip off. actually the back in pretty short time. We got everything off, so I will wool a little. Look at this. All this is yours, yeah. And this I'm stripping partly making a shape on it, but you know, he has still a little of the puppy, young, undercoat kind, where it's a little brownish. You know, you shouldn't be so desperate about the brownish color in this age, because it's just a dead coat and it will adjust. If the dog has good genes, it will adjust. But the brownish, it's not such a big problem. The gray is a problem. This brownish, in my experience, it will simply go off. If the streaming will keep on, I can show you how to make a nice smooth line here between the clipped area and the stripped area, because it never should look, you know, like firm cut and just push on the other side. So you always have to make it smooth. Remove the undercoat. Then you take the thinners, if I can find them in the mess. Okay, let's go on. There was something in the technical, I don't know why, it's just saying some strange things. So here we take all this down to the elbow, and this brown sinks. You can block actually part of it away, because it's just dead coat. It's dead coat. It will... If you would strip it off, they will come great black coat. But of course, you know, we have to be careful that they will be still nice, so... All the way here, down. I know, it's not so nice there, no. Stop it. We are not protesting about this. Listen. I will give him a little pause now. He's starting to protest, so it's not so good to press it through. And his young dog, he shouldn't be forced to anything he doesn't want to. So then when it's pause, a little walk outside, he'll do the trick, that he will cooperate again. You know, always when you have young dogs, always keep the time for them. Give them the pause, play with them in between, you know, they shouldn't have bad experience from it. You never forget you have a live creature on the table. It's not some piece of work. It's just a little dog which is left without his mommy, which is standing in this situation. He doesn't understand really why he is there and why this should happen. So think always, you have a dog there. And talk to them and, you know, give them company. Because it will be back. You will have greatly cooperating dog in the future. Well, now we stripped actually all this. Yeah, this is nasty. Yeah. I'm not biting. Then he danced, so okay, then we will continue somewhere else until you don't like it again. You see, all this I stripped. All this must go off. This to the, because it will show the regulation nicely, and he has good shoulders, good upper arm. It will really show his front in the nice way. You see? You don't have to leave all this bush here because it's not necessary. All this we take off. Lovely head. I enjoyed through the grooming girl to look at nice dog. The same here. All this must go off. And we don't go on compromises in these places. So. I think we will take a break now. I will just try to show you the head a little. How is it done? Well, now he got messed in the eyebrows, but you see. And you see how nicely we cleaned it. The coat is totally short. So all is cleaned. Now we must wait for the new coat. And you see on the head. Yeah, against the lights, it's not so smart. Good boy. That's better. And here you see how we stripped actually this area downstairs, all this, the coat. And this all actually I worked with the with these two knives, they were the best friends. It's the retro edition we have. And then with the professional twinkings, you see all the roots out there. And you had been eating all the hair. Yeah. So I will bring you a little picture when he's finished, because now I think we need a little break, both of us. So thank you for looking, listening, and I will be back.